Let's begin our analysis by looking at an example of a single cambered wing. Okay, so I'm going to draw a wing here, and you can imagine that that wing is going in and out of the page. So we've got this three-dimensional wing that's flying in some hopefully trim and stable conditions. So we're going to look at the most simplified scenario here. Let's say that that the V infinity is aligned with the horizontal, and we've got a center of gravity on the wing here, and so we've got weight acting down. We also have an aerodynamic center. We usually put the aerodynamic forces acting at an aerodynamic center here, and for that we've got lift that's being produced. There's drag, and also a pitching moment. Pitching moment about the aerodynamic center. Now, we're drawing that positive in the nose up direction because remember our y-axis goes out the right-hand side here, and a positive pitching moment, then if you put your thumb out the y-axis, then positive pitching moment is a nose up pitching moment. Okay, and now in order for this to be trim, we're going to have some propulsion system on board. So we've got thrust coming out the nose. Okay, so this is our simplified aircraft here, so we can begin to look at both trim and stability. So let's look at trim over here, and what we're going to pay particular attention to is the location of the aerodynamic center relative to the center of gravity, and the distance aft from the center of gravity that the aerodynamic center is, we'll call that script L sub W. Okay, that's the location of the wing of this single wing relative to the center of gravity, and we'll say the positive is behind the center of gravity. Okay, so for this aircraft to be trim, the sum of the forces and moments have to be equal to zero. So let's do the sum of the forces in the x direction. We get thrust is equal to drag. Some of the forces in the z direction, up and down, is that lift is equal to weight. And then some of the moments about the center of gravity. So let's look at that. Let's look at the pitching moment at the center of gravity is going to be equal to the pitching moment at the aerodynamic center minus L sub w, the distance of that aerodynamic center multiplied by the lift. Now, in order for this to be trim, this has to be equal to zero. So we usually write this in a non-dimensional form. So let's just look at that. If we divide this entire equation by 1/2 rho v squared, we would usually use then the wing area and a mean chord in order to non-dimensionalize that. So what we would get is that the pitching moment at the aerodynamic center, the pitching moment coefficient, is equal to the pitching moment coefficient at the aerodynamic center minus LW over C bar. That C bar and LW will join together because when we non-dimensionalize lift, we actually don't need a C bar in order to non-dimensionalize lift. So we'll have a lift coefficient there divided by C bar. And we're gonna put that C bar with LW because both of those are a length. So that's another non-dimensional term. And so this whole thing is equal to zero. Okay, so this is our requirement to be trim. Now let's solve for L sub W here. So if I just rearrange this, then L sub W is going to be equal to CMAC over CL. Let's see, because I move my CMAC over to the other side, it becomes negative. I divide by CL, and the negatives cancel, and then I've got a C bar out here. So LW is equal to the pitching moment at the aerodynamic center divided by the lift coefficient times C bar. Okay, so C bar is going to be a positive number. The lift coefficient, for our example here, is going to be positive because we're trimming this in steady level flight, and it's offsetting the weight of the aircraft. And the pitching moment at the aerodynamic center of a simply cambered airfoil, which is what I've drawn here, is usually negative. Okay, so with those, with the signs of all those, we know that in order to trim this aircraft, LW has to be less than zero, okay? So in other words, the aerodynamic center here actually has to sit in front of the center of gravity, okay? So LW has to be negative, the aerodynamic center actually has to be in front of the center of gravity in order for us to trim this aircraft. Okay, let's look at stability. And remember, stability along the axes is usually not an issue. Thrust and drag, we talked about that in a previous video, that as we speed up or slow down along the x-axis, thrust and drag are gonna balance to make us stable. That happens with lift and weight as well as we move up and down with an angle of attack. So we're generally stable in along those axes. And the only axis that we're concerned here in terms of the stability about an axis is the y-axis or the pitch axis. Okay, so we need to look at the stability of this wing about the pitch axis, which remember runs into the page here. It goes out the right wing in this drawing here. So go into the page, and so what we want for this wing to be stable, what we need is if we get a disturbance, and let's say that the wing gets disturbed, so it's at a higher angle of attack, then we want the aerodynamics to naturally create a pitching moment that would lower the angle of attack and return it back, so it's pointing back in the direction that it was originally. And likewise, if we got a disturbance to lower the angle of attack, then it would create a pitching moment to increase the angle of attack and return it back to this trim state. And so the way we write that mathematically is that we need the change in pitching moment with respect to alpha to be less than zero. Okay, so let's just think through this really quickly. If we have an increase in angle of attack, we want a negative pitching moment. So as angle of attack increases, then we want a negative pitching moment to push our nose back down. And so that's where the sign of this comes from. With a change in pitching moment with respect to alpha has to be less than zero. We can write that in non-dimensional form. That's usually how we see it, is that the pitching moment with respect to alpha is less than zero. Okay, that comma there means the first derivative of the pitching moment with respect to alpha. Okay, so let's take this equation here. We've got actually an equation for the pitching moment here in non-dimensional form about the center of gravity. And let's just take the derivative of that with respect to alpha. So the change in pitching moment with respect to alpha is equal to the change in pitching moment at the aerodynamic center with respect to alpha, minus, now LW doesn't change with alpha and neither does C bar, so those are constants, multiplied by the change in lift coefficient with respect to alpha. In order for this to be stable, we need this to be less than zero, okay? So let's look through each of these terms. The pitching moment about the aerodynamic center with respect to alpha is actually zero. That's the definition of the aerodynamic center, is that the pitching moment doesn't change with changes in angle of attack. And so what we're left with here is minus LW over C bar times CL alpha has to be less than zero. Okay, so let's look at the signs of each of these. The CL alpha is the lift slope of this wing, and that is obviously going to be positive. As we increased angle of attack, we'll have an increase in lift slope. C bar is again positive. And so actually, in order for this to be true, LW we see has to be actually greater than zero, because we have a negative out front here. We've got this negative right here. And so this actually needs to be a positive in order for this whole term to be less than zero, for this system to be stable in pitch. So we see that the requirement is that LW is greater than zero, or in other words, that our aerodynamic center has to sit behind the center of gravity. Okay, so we have two competing requirements here. The first says that the aerodynamic center needs to sit in front of the center of gravity in order to trim the aircraft, right? But in order for us to be stable, the aerodynamic center actually has to sit behind the center of gravity. So how do we solve this? Well, there are a few different ways to solve this. We're going to talk about two of them. The first one is something that you see on flying wings. And first of all, I guess I should point out, this is why we don't see aircraft with only a single wing that has what we call a simple camber, okay, or simply cambered airfoil, meaning that we just have a curvature that's going in one direction here. So this is a simply cambered airfoil, and one way to solve this is actually to use what's called a reflexed airfoil. And so for an airfoil, so this is what a reflexed airfoil would look like, where we have positive camber here at the front of the airfoil, and then we actually have some negative air camber back here. And what that does is, most aircraft, or a simply cambered airfoil, let me just draw that here. If we have a simply cambered airfoil, that will create a pitching moment about the aerodynamic center that is negative. Okay, it's usually creating a nose down pitching moment, but if we have a reflex airfoil, then we can create a pitching moment about the aerodynamic center that's positive. So what this allows us to do with this reflexed airfoil is actually change the sign of this term here. So that becomes a positive. And if all three of these are positive, then we see that the LW then can be greater than zero, or would be greater than zero, in order to satisfy the trim requirement here, okay? And so the stability requirement stays the same. So what we usually see is that we're going to have an aerodynamic center behind the center of gravity. If we only have a single wing, then we have to have some way of making the pitching moment positive. And we can do that without sweep by putting in this reflexed airfoil. Another way to handle this is to sweep the wing. And so that's why you see flying wings out there. RC, or like the B-2 bomber or other aircraft that just have a single wing, well, they sweep back that wing, and that that produces the same type of effect, although they can just maintain the simple camber over the entire wing. By sweeping it, they get a positive pitching moment. Another way to handle this is actually to add a horizontal, what we're going to call a horizontal stabilizer, and that's an additional wing back here, well behind the center of gravity. And so we're going to call this L sub H. This is the distance aft to the aerodynamic center of a horizontal stabilizer. And so that will be creating lift and also drag. So that's the lift on the horizontal and the drag on the horizontal. And that scenario is the topic of the next video.